Hi viewers, today we are discussing about Lycopodia. It is one of the division of pteridophytes. So it is the one of the division, that is Lycopodia. The Lycopodia division shows some peculiar characters. They are Eusporangium, means entire sporangium origin from group of incials is called Eusporangium. Another one is heterosporous, means all the spores are equal in size. Heterosporous means two different sizes of spores are forming on same plant is called heterosporous. Another one is sporophyll. Phyll means leaf. Sporo means spores containing leaf is called sporophyll. These sporophylls are aggregated and form like a cone. These cones are called strobilus. How these strobilus are formed? The aggregation of many sporophylls to form a cone-like structure. That cone is called strobilus. Once again, define sporophyll. Sporangium containing leaves are called sporophyll. Now, in some species of Lycopodia has microphyll. Microphyll means, phyll means leaf. Micro means small size leaf. The leaf has only one midrib. There is no lateral venation. The bottom of this leaf has quiescent shape of structure. The quiescent shape of structure is called glossopodium. It is the microphyll. The microphyll has only midrib. There is no lateral veins. The base of the microphyll has leaf-like structure is called ligule. Again, the ligule, the base has quiescent structure is called glossopodium. So, glossopodium, ligule and leaf. It is the structure of ligule. Some plants has ligule. Some plants does not have ligule. Based on the presence of ligule, the Lycopodia divided into two class. One is class, one is E-ligulopsida. Means there is no ligule. Example, Lycopodiales. Example, Lycopodium. Order is Lycopodiales. Example, Lycopodium. So in Lycopodium, no ligule. The second class is Ligulopsida, means the class plants contain ligule. It has four orders. Selaginellales, example Selaginella, Lepidodendrales, example Lepidodendron, Isoites, example Isoites, Fluromiales, example Fluromia. Totally four orders has ligule. Once again, ligule means the microphyll base as leaf-like structure is called ligule. Again, the ligule bottom has quiescent shape structure. That quiescent shape structure of group of the cells is called glossopodium. The entire structure is called ligule. Now, discussion about Lycopodium. The systematic position, division, Lycopodia, class E. Ligulopsida means there is no ligule. Order Lycopodials. Family Lycopodiaceae. Genus Lycopodium. Generally the Lycopodium is called club mosses, creeping pines or ground pines. So it is important, club mosses. Almost this plant resembling with bryophyta moss plants. That's why it is called club mosses. The plant has strobilus like sporophylls. So it is a creeping. Hence looks like a pinus plants, cone plants. So it is called creeping pine or ground pine. Now we are discussing of Lycopodium plant. Here it is the Lycopodium plant. The Lycopodium plant usually is called sporophyte. The sporophyte is diploid in condition, means every cell of the plant has diploid in condition. Here the plant has three parts. One is root, another one is stem, another one is leaves. So the roots are dichotomous branching. The stems are shows dichotomous branching. Both are shows dichotomous branching. The roots help fix in the soil. Then the roots arouse at the bottom of the creeping stem. The creeping stem usually is called rhizome. The rhizome arouses branches. These branches are prostrate, erect, and every branch with dichotomous green colored. In some species, the apical leaves are aggregated to form a cone-like structure. These cones are called strobilus. Looks like a flower, but not they are not flowers. They are a strobilus or cones. So appearance looks like a gymnosperm. So they are called ground pine or creeping pine. Now these Lycopodium genera divided into two types. One genera is Eurostachya, another genera is Rafflostachya. The Lycopodium genera divided into two type of the genera. One is Eurostachya. Eurostachya means these Lycopodium species are live as epiphytes. Epiphytes means these are living on another plants. So these plants are greenish color. They are creeping with epiphytic lifestyle. Example, Lycopodium selago, Lycopodium plagmaria, Lycopodium lucidum, lucidulum. So the Eurostachya identification is, the lifestyle is epiphytic lifestyle. Green color, dichotomous branching. The another one, Rafflostachya. The Rafflostachya means these plants are growing as creeping on ground and prostrate with branching. For example, Lycopodium cernuum, Lycopodium clavatum, Lycopodium inundatum. Inundatum. So these species are shows Rafflostachya. Now what is the major difference in between Eurostachya and Rafflostachya? All the Eurostachya members growing as epiphytes. All the Rafflostachya members are growing on ground with creeping prostrate. So based on the plants growing area, these genera are divided into two types, Eurostachya and Rafflostachya. One more point, on dichotomous stems, the leaves all are the microphylls. These all microphylls are arranged as spirally. So the leaves arrangement is spirally. The leaves are sessile leaves. There is no venation. Looks like this manner. Only one midrib is present. No petiole, no lateral veins. Simply the leaf is greenish color with veinless leaflet. These are the microphylls. Next, TS of root. It is the root anatomy. It shows three parts. One is epidermis, another one is cortex, another one is central cylinder or vascular cylinder. Vascular cylinder. So the TS of root shows three regions: epidermis, cortex, vascular cylinder. This is the epidermis, a single cell thick layer. It is the epidermis, no intercellular spaces. One cell produces two roots. One cell produces two roots. So it is identification character. Two roots are origin from single cell. Beneath the epidermis, it is the cortex. The cortex divided into two regions: outermost cortex, innermost cortex. The outermost cortex made by sclerenchyma. It provides mechanical strength to the root. The innermost cortex made by simple parenchyma. So storage of food material, it helps. Here no endodermis, no pericycle. Just only vascular bundle is present. Vascular tissues are present. It is the xylem. The red color shows indicate xylem. The xylem shape is U shape or C shape. The smaller one tracheid is protoxylem. The big size tracheid is metaxylem. In between two protoxylem, the phloem is filled. Green color indicate phloem. So simply xylem and phloem both together are present. The arrangement is maybe uni-arc. Maybe at maturity it turn into convert into triarch or diarch. But the xylem looks like a U-shaped. Now the TS of stem. It is the TS of stem structure. The stem has, the surface is zigzag, irregular. Means it shows ridges and furrows. Ridges, furrows. Ridges, furrows. So it is the enlarged sector. The stem shows again three regions like epidermis, cortex, vascular cylinder. So the stem TS shows three regions: epidermis, cortex, vascular cylinder. So this is the epidermis, single cell thick. There is no intercellular spaces, with encloses with cuticle. Beneath the epidermis, the entire region is called cortex. The cortex divided into three regions: outermost cortex, middle cortex from here to here, and inner cortex. So the cortex is too long. The cortex occupied many portion. It divided into three region: outermost, middle, and innermost. Outer and inner made by sclerenchyma. They provide mechanical strength. The middle cortex made by parenchyma. Maybe it perform photosynthesis. Then endodermis is there. It made by some cells or Casparian bands. Some are without Casparian bonds. They are working as a passage cells, transfusion cell. Beneath the endodermis, 2-3 layers, maybe 2-3 layers of pericycle is there. The original pericycle is arose. And these are xylem strands, pink color. Alternate green color is there. The green color is phloem tissue. So xylem strands, phloem, xylem, phloem. There is no cambium. That's why this type of steel is called protosteel. So the Lycopodium species shows protosteel. Protosteel means simply xylem and phloem together is present, is called protosteel. So now protosteel. The protostele means xylem and phloem, both are together, are present, is called protostele. Proto means first, primary, firstly originated. Such type of steel is called protostele. This protostele divided into many types, like simple protostele, plectostele, actinostele, mixed protostele. It divided into four types based on arrangement of xylem tracheids. So which character? Based on xylem tracheid arrangement, this protostele divided into four types in Lycopodium species. So in Lycopodium species, they shows diversified stele. The first one, simple protostele. This is the simple protostele. The xylem is centric, surrounding by phloem, both together present in center of the stem. Such type of steel is called simple protostele. Example, Lycopodium selago. And before examples also there, Rhynia, Psilotum. So it is important for entrances. So simple protostele present in which plants? Rhynia, Psilotum and Lycopodium selago. Simple stele means the xylem located at center and surrounding by phloem. Such type of stele is called simple protostele. Then another one, plectoprotostele. Simply plectostele. Example, Lycopodium clavatum, Lycopodium volubile. In these plants, these are tracheid strands. The tracheid strands looks like a plates or striped. Every stripe alternate with phloem. Tracheid strand, phloem. Tracheid strand, phloem. These are present alternating, xylem and phloem, xylem and phloem. Such type of plate-like structure steel is called plectoprotostele. So it is advanced than simple protostele. Another one, actinostele. Actino means star or stellate. So the tracheid, the xylem arrangement as stellate manner, star manner. It is one stellate, it is one ray, it is another ray, it is another ray. The red color shows tracheids, xylem strand. With phloem, green color, xylem, phloem alternate. Anyhow, the xylem is center, enclosed with the phloem, surrounding with the phloem. But the xylem tracheids arrangement is stellate manner, rays. That's why the stele is called actinostele or stellate protostele. Example, Lycopodium serratum. Another one, mixed protostele. Example, Lycopodium cernuum. In Lycopodium cernuum, the tracheids and phloem are mixed to each other. These are tracheids group. The tracheid groups are surrounding with phloem. Many tracheid groups are there with surrounding phloem. These arrangement is a groups. Such type of protostele is called mixed protostele. So how many in Lycopodium species are shows diversifying? Four types: simple protostele, plectostele, actinostele, mixed protostele. Out of these four, which is the advanced? The mixed protostele is advanced. Which is the ancient? The simple protostele is ancient, starting stele. It is present in Rhynia, Psilotum and Lycopodium selago. Now, reproduction. The Lycopodium performing by three methods: vegetative reproduction, asexual and sexual. Vegetative reproduction by fragmentation. Fragmentation are adventitious roots. adventitious are bulbils. Adventitious birds and bulbils. Asexual reproduction by homospores. Sexual reproduction is commonly antheridium and archegonium. So chemotactic sexual reproduction takes place. Let us discussion about asexual reproduction in Lycopodium species. It is the Lycopodium cone, strobili. This is called strobili, strobilus. Strobilus means the aggregation of many microphylls to form a cone-like structure is called strobili. These all are microphylls, means leaves, small leaves. It is a single leaf microphyll. Some leaves contain sporangium, so that is called sporophyll. Without sporangium leaves, usually called common leaf microphyll. If that leaf contains sporangium, that leaf is called sporophyll. So it is erect. The sporophyll contains sporangium. Which type of the sporangium? Eusporangiate. Eusporangiate type of sporangium. Eusporangiate means the entire sporangium origin from group of the initials. Group of the initials means many cells are involving in the formation of sporangium. It is one sporangium. Every microphyll has sporangium. These red color symbols all are sporangium. One sporangium enlarged sector. This is enlarged figure. So it is the multicellular stalk. It is kidney shaped sporangium. The sporangial wall contain three layers. Outer two layers is the wall layer, and the innermost layer is called tapetum. The tapetum function is nourished to the spores, means the tapetum supplies nutrients to the growing spores. When inside of the sporangium, archisporial cell, sporogenous mother cells. Sporogenous mother cells means SMC. These mother cells are go to meiosis to form a tetrads. Tetra means four. The group of four spores are called tetrad. After meiosis, many tetrads are forming. Every meiosis takes place at SMC, means spore mother cell. This reduction division gives many tetrads. Every tetrad contain four haploid spores. They are called spores. After maturity, the tip of the sporangium go to ruptured and form a hole that is called stomium. Among the stomium, many spores are releases into the ground. This is the one single spore. It is haploid in condition. The spore contain triradiate ridge. It is the identification character of spore. Now, the development of spore. So, spore development. When shed down the ground, after few years, maybe it takes a lot of time, 3 to 8 years. When the favorable conditions are available, the spore go to germinate by the many common divisions. The spore go to one common division, irregular division, asymmetrical division. The division name is asymmetrical, means unequal division. The unequal division gives unequal cells. The lower small cell is rhizoidal cell. It is the large cell. Again, the large cell divided into two common divisions, longitudinal vertical divisions. This vertical division gives one basal cell or supporting cell and apical cell. Now the spore contain three cells. So it is the asymmetrical division, it is the vertical division. Now two oblique divisions are forming. It is one oblique division, it is another oblique division in apical cell. So the apical cell goes to two oblique divisions. One is this one, another one is this one. Now five cells are forming. Now it is called five-celled stage of spore. What are they? Rhizoidal cell, basal cell, apical cell, a common oblique cells, totally 5-celled, spore wall. One more important character, the spore surroundings with two layers. Two-layered spores are present with triradiate ridge. Now, germination of spore or gametophyte structure. Now, discussion about structure of gametophyte. When the spore can germinate to gives rise to juvenile gametophyte. The juvenile gametophyte is called prothallus. In Lycopodium species, three type of the gametophytes are identified by Troob. Year 1998. Important. Troob. Troob explained in Lycopodium species, the juvenile gametophyte or prothalluses are three types. One is first type gametophyte or prothallus, second type prothallus, third type prothallus. Who divided three type of the gametophytes in Lycopodium? Troob. In which year? 1998. Later, Brookman also supported. In Lycopodium shows three type of the prothallus. Any difference in between gametophyte and prothallus? The juvenile stage of gametophyte is called prothallus. The matured gametophyte is called, or sexual organs bearing gametophyte is called a mature gametophyte. Now we are discussing prothallus types. First type of prothallus, second type of prothallus, third type of prothallus. Now this is the first type of prothallus. Example, Lycopodium cernuum. Type is 1. It is Lycopodium cernuum. It grows on soil. Almost 3/4 of the portion placed in the underground, means embedded in soil. It has many rhizoids. One more important, the embedded which portion present in the ground? It is with mycorrhiza. Without mycorrhiza, the Lycopodium gametophyte cannot shows grown. Mycorrhiza. The mycorrhiza belongs to phycomycetes. Myco means root. Rhiza means fungus. Rhiza means root. Rhiza means root. Myco means fungus. Some fungi symbiosis on other plant roots. Such type of fungus is called mycorrhiza. The mycorrhizas collecting phosphates from the soil and supply to the plants. Sometimes water also absorbs. So almost the root function performing by mycorrhiza. Instead of the root, the mycorrhiza collecting water mineral from the soil along with phosphates to supply to the plant. That's why it is help to the plant. It is lifestyle is symbiosis. Now this is the Lycopodium cernuum. The underground part contain mycorrhiza. The surface portions are greenish color. These are branches. The surface branches has sexual organs. So it is antheridium. It is archegonium. It bears both. So the character is called monoecious. Almost many Lycopodium species shows monoecious. Hence protandrous character. Protandrous means first the male organ matures, then female organ. That character is called protandry. Monoecious means male and female sexual organs present on same plant. That character is called monoecious. So it is a type 1. In type 1, the gametophyte is short-lived, annual plant. Maybe it is living live as 1 year. After it goes to decayed and died. Short-lived gametophyte or prothallus. Next, second type of the prothalli. Example, Lycopodium clavatum, Lycopodium complanatum. So, Lycopodium complanatum, Lycopodium clavatum, both are type 2 prothallus. The type 2 prothallus, for example, Lycopodium clavatum, it is looks like a top shaped. And perennial, green colored, perennial plant. This is the perennial gametophyte. It has a top shaped. These are the rhizoids, roots. It has three regions. It is the peripheral surface region, it is the middle region, it is the inner region. The middle region is storage region. It is called storage. It made by parenchyma. And surface region with mycorrhiza. Mycorrhiza produces rhizoids. Instead of roots, the mycorrhiza collect water mineral from the soil. In this gametophyte, the roots are not forming. The mycorrhizal rhizoids are collecting. These rhizoids are mycorrhiza. These are belongs to fungal. It is parenchymatous. And bears sexual organs. At the center portion has antheridia and ridges has archegonia. It is fertilized archegonia embryo, this one. So the peripheral, the edges has archegonia, the center has antheridia. In Lycopodium complanatum, it looks like a carrot-like appearance or fusiform. Carrot-like appearance, green colored. This portion is colorless, but carrot-like appearance. So the surface portion has archegonium. These all are archegoniums. At the center region has antheridiums. Both sexual organs are present. And this is the storage tissue. At both side with palisade cells. These are palisade cells. And the green colored mycorrhizal layers. These are mycorrhizal layers. These are mycorrhizal rhizoids. The rhizoids are help fixation and collection of water mineral from the soil. So the mycorrhiza living as symbiont. Storage tissue, palisade tissue, mycorrhizal layer with rhizoids. These are sexual organs. It is the second type gametophyte. And third type gametophyte. This is the third type. Example, Lycopodium plugmeria. The Lycopodium plugmeria